Hello out there, everyone. Today I'm going to talk briefly about this wonderful Scream Factory collector's edition of The Howling, a 1981 werewolf film that is often the undercard to the more famous American Werewolf in London. Now, what's interesting about this film is it's actually written by John Sayles, and for those of you who've seen movies, you might have come across some of his work. He's a fabulous writer, director, mostly of independent fare, but he did make a living doing some screenwriting. And one of the things that he wrote was this wonderful werewolf film based upon source material that ultimately bears little resemblance to the film that was made. What also is unique about this film is just how incredibly tactile all the effect work was. Apparently, none other than Rick Baker was going to be making the werewolves in this film, but he got called by John Landis to go and work on American Werewolf in London. So he basically got the pre-production going and then handed it over to a young understudy named Rob Bottin, who is a fabulous makeup artist who's done some of the most incredible practical effect work that you've seen, most notably in The Thing, Total Recall, RoboCop. I mean, the guy is a legend. But this film, what really makes it, I think, stand apart from American Werewolf in London and really arguably make it a better film is John Sayles' script. It's razor sharp. It has a lot of very interesting things to say about, you know, animalism and civilization, and it doesn't hit you over the head with it. It's pretty clever. Now, being that it's a 1981 film set in a city and then later on a resort or a retreat colony, there is inevitably a little bit of the roughness that you would expect from that time period, especially when it comes to a treatment toward women. So there might be a cringy moment or two in there that's, you know, it's warts and all. It's still definitely worth a watch and a fabulous example of what can be accomplished with practical effects. I think, you know, they blow out of the water anything done in the CGI environment, even to this day. So again, what I would just say is seek this film out. It's a hoot. It's funny. It's scary. Joe Dante directs, who of course later went on to do the Gremlins, Gremlins 1 and 2, and it's just a remarkable little piece of horror cinema. So with that, take care, stay safe, and until the next time.